Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to describe the transformations of a function algebraically. To complete this problem, we'll first identify the transformations we need to describe, and then show algebraically how each of these transformations will affect our original function. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been given the function, or the theoretical function, y equals f of x, and asked to algebraically describe the following transformations of y equals f of x. So what they're basically saying here is that we haven't been given f of x explicitly. It could be anything. It could be x plus 7. It could be x cubed plus x squared minus 4. It could be any function. But they're saying, given any function, perform the following transformations and indicate what that transformation would look like in conjunction here with f of x. So this will be just a great overview for how to perform the following transformations and should give you a better idea of how to look for transformations when you see them. So given y equals f of x, if we want to shift that graph, remember no matter what it is, but we want to shift it up 3 units, then our function would be y equals f of x plus 3. And that's easy to understand because no matter what we plug in for x here, the resulting y value would be 3 units more if we just add 3. So it would be a vertical shift up 3. And the same will go for shifting down 3, we'll just get y equals f of x minus 3. This would shift the graph down vertically 3 units. When we're talking about shifting left and right, we have a similar concept except that this plus 3 and negative 3 here needs to be included in the function. So instead of having it be separate, right, here we've kind of just separately added on a plus 3 and separately added on a negative 3. But in this case, if we want to shift right 3 units, then our function will be y equals f of x minus 3. So instead of just adding 3 or subtracting 3 separate from and outside of this f of x function, it's integrated inside of the function, which means that if our original function were, let's say, x cubed, and we wanted to shift it right 3 units, we would have to plug in x minus 3 for x, and we get the quantity x minus 3 cubed. So we really have to incorporate that negative 3. And it's somewhat counterintuitive that it's a minus 3 when we're shifting to the right, but it is opposite like that from what you would think. It's minus 3 here. Shifting left 3 units is y equals f of x plus 3. So again, and maybe we can go through and do this here, if we had a function y equals, let's say, x squared, right? Then our transformation here to shift up 3 would just be x squared plus 3. To shift down 3 would be x squared minus 3. To shift to the right would be y equals x minus 3 squared. And to shift to the left would be y equals the quantity x plus 3 squared. So you can see the difference there. If we're going to reflect about the x-axis, that means we're going to flip it over the x-axis exactly where it is, we'll get y equals negative f of x. So we just add that negative out in front of the f of x, or multiply it by negative 1. If we want to reflect about the y-axis, we have to incorporate that negative inside of our f of x, and we'll get f of negative x. So that's the difference here, and the transformation looks like this. Again, if we have the function y squared, then we would get y equals negative, or sorry, x squared, we would get y equals negative x squared to flip it over the x-axis. We would get y equals negative x squared to flip it over the y-axis. And finally, if we want to stretch vertically by a factor of 3 or shrink vertically by a factor of 3, then our functions look like this. To stretch vertically, we want to say y equals 3 times f of x. That means every y-coordinate on our original function, x squared, will now be 3 times what it was in the original function. If we shrink vertically, we want to say y equals 1/3 f of x, and every y-coordinate that was on our original graph will now be 1/3 what it was originally. What that looks like here, of course, is y equals 3x squared and y equals 1/3 x squared. And we won't take the time to do it here, but if you started with the function x squared and you graphed all of these transformations,
you would see visually how the graph would get shifted up 3 units, down 3 units, to the right, to the left, etc. And that's it. That's just a basic overview of transformations of functions up, down, right, left, and flipping over the x and y axis and stretching and shrinking.
So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.